Hi all, welcome back. Welcome back to the next session on lab experiment of microprocessor and microcontroller and embedded system. Okay. Now we will discuss today on the program PIP experiment. Write program to find square of 1 to 10 using lookup table. Okay. So first look into the what is mean by lookup table. Okay, and that will with the help of the table, you have to find the square root of a given number. Okay. Sorry, square of a given number. Okay, look at the first the slides. Okay. What is mean by a lookup table? Lookup table, also known as in short LUT, is an array. Now keep in mind that it is an array used in computer program that holds value which would otherwise need to be calculated. The table may be manually populated when the program is written, or the program may populate the table with values as it calculates them. When the values are needed later, the program can look them up from the table. Okay. So LUT is nothing but there are predefined values or pre-calculated values you can store it in the array form. Okay. Now, for example, the example I mentioned here, name of the months, name of the days, now square root, square of number. Okay. So where we, for example, in the case of name of the month, so we don't have any formula for that. Only names are fixed, like January, February up to December. Only 12 names are there for months. Okay. So there is no calculation. So manually you have to enter it. Or you can use some formula based to calculation pre-calculated values also. Okay. Now a good example nowadays more or used in the digital cameras. Okay. The LUT tables are where used to you can enhance the captured images, or you can do immediately changes in your photo, whatever captured photos are there. You can do the changes in that. We can crop it, or we can brightness, we can increase contrast, you can change it. This is because of LUT only. Okay. Now today our discussion more on square of number. Okay. Now we'll come to the program part now. Now here I am using some variables to define the square of number. I'll store the 1 to 10 square of that each number. Then for which value you want, you are finding the square of that number, and another variable is to result now. Okay. Now here you can observe that. Just wait a minute. I'll now here one more row is unnecessary created, and delete this. You can observe that I am using the name of the variable as square LUT, okay, where I am storing the square of each number starting from 1 to 10. Okay, so this complete stored information we call it as LUT, lookup table. Okay, so the square of 1 is stored at memory location 0. Now let's assume that we are working with a 32-bit number. It become easier because ARM usually supports 32-bit accessing data from the memory. Okay. Now square of 2 is stored at 4. Okay. Because as need a 4 memory location to store each square of each number. Similarly for 3 it is at 8. Now for 4 at 12, so on up to 10 at 24 in hexadecimal, and decimal it is 36. Okay. In bracket all values are given, all are in decimal. Careful observe that. And whatever matrices are mentioned, all are in hex. Okay. These are all are in hex. Okay. Right here, hex. Okay. And these are all in decimal. Okay. Now, you can observe that here, these are all square of a number. These are all square of each number from 1 to 10. And one more variable I used, value. For which number you are finding the square of number from this LOT table. Okay. And the last one, third variable is result. So after finding the square of that given number or given value, that going to store it in the variable result. Okay. Now, the LUT and value you have to define it in the ROM. The all the two variables square LUT and value, you have to define it in the ROM because only you are reading this one. Okay. Then result you are writing it to store it in the RAM. Okay, that is result variable. Now think of that, the LUT always stored at 0th memory location and end at 24 in the hexadecimal. It's not like that. It depends on the Kyle compiler. It allocate automatically allocate the memory location. Okay. Here I took the example to easy to understand what logic you have to apply it. Okay. The same logical is applied to if LUT is stored at any memory location. Okay. Now let's assume that I'll store this value in resistor R0. Okay. Now to get the square of the each number. Okay. Let's assume that I want square of given value is 1. And as this LUT acts as an array, so that's why I need one pointer to point to this variable square LUT. I'll use the pointer as R1 now. Okay. So R1 you can use it to hold the address, beginning address of LUT. Okay. Then now how to find this one now from this given table? Nothing but the array should be scanned it such a way that we have to find the square of the given number is 1. The square of decimal 1 is 1, which is stored at 0th memory location. Okay. So 0th memory, no problem, nothing but where the R1 is pointing, from the same memory location you get the square of 1. If you given the value is 2, okay, instead of 1, if you given the 2, the 2 square is 4. Carefully observe that, and which is stored at memory location 604. Okay, everyone got the point now. Nothing but each number we need 4 memory location. Similarly, if value is 3, the square is 9, which is stored at 8. Now similarly for 4, 16, which is stored at C in decimal 12. Okay, so on up to 10th one. Okay. Now you can observe that each square number, square of each number is stored in successive 4 memory location. Nothing but 32-bit data, so 4 memory locations are stored. Okay. You can observe that first one is stored at 0, then next 4, next one is 8, next C, that is in decimal 12, next is 16 in decimal 10, in hexadecimal 10, then 10, then 20, 24, 28, 34, 36, nothing but each having the 4 differences are there. Okay. Now if given number is 1, if your given value is 1, that will come back. If the given value is 1, so there is no change in the R1 value. There is no change in that. So from the same pointer address, we can access the value. Okay. Now, if any other number is there, so how to get the address of that number? Now, for example, if number is 2 is there, so which is stored at memory location 4. Nothing but R1 content, I have to add how much to this 4, I have to add it. Okay. Then we'll get this address. So I can access the square of 2. Similarly, if I number is 3, so how much I have to add? I have to add 8 now. Okay. Similarly, for 4, I have to add 12. Similarly, for 5, so I have to add 16. Okay. So on multiple of 4. So how we can use multiple of 4? We can use multiply instruction, or better preferably use the logical left shift. Nothing but if you shift once, it is nothing but multiply by 2. If you shift twice, it is nothing but multiply by 4. Okay. Now it's not mean that if you want memory location 8 thrice at a shift, if you want to tell 4 times at a shift. So shift how many times is depends. Now shifting is nothing but multiple of 4. So this multiple of 4 is depend on this given value. Okay. Now let's look at one example. We'll come to know that and start from the beginning. R0, this is R1. So how to calculate the memory address of each square of each number now? Okay, so R1, how much number I have to add to the R1 so that I'll get the exact location of square of that number. Okay, if your given number is 1 now, let assume that if you write here R0 into 4. So R1 plus, if R0 is 1 into 4. Okay. Now right now content of R1 is 00. 00 plus 4. And nothing but it pointing at square of 2. It's not pointing square of 1. Not pointing the memory location of square of 2. Instead of pointing the square of address of square of 1. So what will do it? Now you can observe that instead of, if your given value is 1, let assume that, now in the meantime I'll remove this one. If I'm R content of R0 minus 1, and that I multiplied by 4 or logically shift by twice towards left side, and that sum if I added to R1, and if I store it into the back to R1, so it will exactly point to the required memory address from LUT from the given value. Okay. For example, if R0 is 1 minus 1 is 0 into 4. So 0 into 4 is again 0. So that 0 is again added to the R1. So nothing but will pointing at the same memory location. There is no change in the R1. It will copy the square of 1 from the memory location to the result. Okay. Now if value is 2, now 2 minus 1, how much will you get? That is 2 minus 1 is 1. 1 into 4, 4 will get. That 4 is added to the beginning address of LUT, that is this all 8 zeros. So 8 zeros plus 4, so you'll get the address of your square of 2. Address of square of 2, that is 4 is stored in that memory location. Okay, so it will access that data, so with the help of register R1 pointer. Similarly, if the number is 3 minus 1 into 4. Okay, 3 minus 1 into 4. Now 3 minus 1 to 4 is 2 into 4 is 8. Now square of 3 is 9, which is stored at memory location 8, and beginning address of R1 is 8 zeros plus 8, nothing but 6 zeros 8. We'll get the memory address of square of 3. Okay, a similar technique will apply to the all other number from up to 10. Okay, so after getting the exact memory address with the help of this logic, which is copied in the R1, with the help of R1 we can copy that result to another register. So with the help of indirect addressing mode or register indirect addressing mode, we'll put in square bracket, that will copy to register R2. So your square is available, square of that given number available in R2. R0 is to hold the value, R1 will hold the address of square LUT, then R2 holds the result square of result given number, then from R2 will copy that value, copy to the your variable result. Okay, so nothing but we need one more pointer which holds the address of result, that is R3. So with the help of store instruction, we can store the result into the variable result. Okay, with the help of load instruction, we can get the value of LUT and copy to the R2. Okay, then come to the program part. Okay, now here, so already I written that this is your code part, so only I need to write the complete program here, and this is your LUT and declared in the ROM. Okay, with along with the one more variable value 2. So this is, I am finding the square of 2 from this given LUT, and after finding that, I'll store it in result in the RAM. Okay, this is your RAM now, and all I am working with the 32 bit data. Okay, keep in mind that. Now I'll start with the first, I'll get the value into the R0, as I you can observe that in the logic in the slides I shown that LDR R0 comma given value. Okay, it will copy directly value, that is 2, to the R0. Then before the value is used, it I need to subtract it by 1, then multiply it by 4. Okay, so I'll use the sub R0 comma hash 1, subtract it by 1. Okay, then that is multiplied by with the help of logical left shift by twice. So I'll use the R0 comma LSL hash 2, twice has shifted, nothing but this part indicates you are multiplying the content of R0 by 4. Okay, then that we need to add to the content of R1 now. Okay, now content of R1, how to get the content of, nothing but R1 should point to this variable square. Okay, now you can observe that now I need to point this variable LUT by R1. So with the help of LDR instruction, I'll use the LDR R1 comma, I need address because I am accessing the array, so I'll use the variable on square LUT. Okay, so I got the address. Now I need the that content of R0 must have to need to add to the content of R1, so I'll use the add R1 comma R0. Okay, so nothing but content of R1 and R0 is added and stored it into register R1. Okay, after that, now I got the address of that square number which is available in the LUT, so I need to copy to register R2, just now I discussed in the slide. Okay, so with the help of LDR again, LDR R2 comma in square bracket R1. Okay, fine, now we have stored the result is available in R2. That square of number I need to copy to the variable result now. So I need one more register should point with the R3. Okay, so how we can do this one again, same thing, similar method. Get the address of your variable, get the address of your variable result, that is with the help of LDR R3 comma equal RVSU result. Okay, Now you are pointing R3 pointing to the result now. So from now you are square of that given number available in R2, that you copy to the memory pointed by R3. Nothing, we store it in the result store your result in the variable result now. So how can same again str R2 comma whatever in R2 available the square of that number. Okay, in square bracket R3. Okay. Now the result is stored. So this is your program. Okay. So first one, get the value for which value you are finding the square. Subtract it by 1, then multiply that by 4 with the help of logical left shift. Then get the address of your LUT. Given the LUT name, I am using the square LUT. Then that add the content of your R0. R0 content by subtract by 1, then multiply by 4, and that is added to the content of R1. Okay. Then get the value with the help of R1, we'll get the square of that number, and that we can store it in the variable result variable. Okay, with the help of store instruction. Okay, now we'll save this one and translate. Check for any error or not. So in error, square is not defined external internal. Oh, the square spelling is wrong. Okay. Now zero errors, zero warning. Okay. Then debug it. You can observe that this is your memory one. Memory one nothing but your ROM, where I stored the square of each number here. You can observe that here now. This is 1, 4, 9, 10, nothing but 16. Okay, in hexadecimal. Okay, hexadecimal 10. This is 19, 24, 31, 40, 51, 60, 64 is nothing but square in decimal 100. Now here, I'll run it by one, step by step. Okay. Now first, where the value is stored. The value, I need the square of 2. Now right now I'm finding the square of 2. So this I need to copy to register R0. Okay. Now here 2. Okay. Then subtract it by 1. It become 1, then multiplied by 4, it become 4. Okay, 1 into 4 is 4. Will get that 4. We need to add to the content of R1, so we need to get the address of square LUT. Next, we got the address 24. Here you can observe 24. This is the beginning of your LUT. This is part is beginning of LUT. Now that is you have copied in the R1. This 24 need to add with the content of R0, it become 28. So because now you can observe that at memory location 28 is available, the square of your given number is 2. 2 square is 4. That we will going to copy it into the R2. Yeah. Okay. Now step by step. Now R2 has become 4. From this R2, we will copy this into the variable which is stored in RAM. Okay, that is a result variable. So first we need to get the address of result variable into the R3. That is 470s. Then nothing but here memory 2, nothing but your RAM 470. Right now it is 00. There is no nothing is stored here. Okay, nothing is there here. Okay. Now we can check that the content of here the RAM location 470, which is nothing but the memory address of result variable. Okay. Now the 4 is stored here. You can observe 4 is stored. Okay. Now similarly, the 4 is stored. Now we got the square of number 2. Similarly, we can change the value to any other number. For example, I'll use the square to find square of 8. I'll say this one, translate, debug. Now directly I can run this one. here run, then stop it. Now you can observe that it become 40. 40 is in hexadecimal, keep in mind that. And which is, if you convert this hexadecimal number into decimal, you will get the 64. Square of 8 is 64. That also I will show this one. And its calculator. Now, what we got the result? 40. 4 0. Okay, 4 0 in hexadecimal, in decimal it is 64, and the square of 8 is 64. Now this way you got the result. We can find the square of any other number, but as per our the aim, it is to write, to get the square of number from 1 to 10. Okay, you can increase or decrease the size also, but as per the aim of experiment, going up to 1 to 10. Okay, you can try for any other number. And to write the output, to write output of this program, so I have to write the, these are all your input. And this is in the RAM, is your output. You can use you can write the result for two set of results. Okay, this part which I selected part is there, that you have to write. This is example I am done for two square of, finding the square of 2 and finding square of 8. You can try it for any other number and you can write the result. Okay. In the next session, we'll start with the next program, that is the sixth one. Write program to find largest or smallest number in an array of 32-bit number. Okay, if given number is 32, it become easier in the ARM. It does not take much effort, because easily it can work. If it is 16-bit or 8-bit, then we need to think about alignment problem we're going to face. Okay, in next session, we'll look into the program number 6. Okay, thank you.